I would say the last three albums I made have been my favorite. They've been really fun. It's been really fun to kind of pick a theme. And for this one, like really diving into my high school days and remembering a lot of the people from back then. And it felt very natural. It flowed very well. And you said earlier, it kind of feels like a 90s movie. And that's what always was weird. I never really liked high school movies because they don't feel like what Blair felt like. You could be really popular in one hallway, but then I would go over one hallway and everyone's speaking Vietnamese and they don't give a damn about what I want to do or what I like, you know? There was something really grounding about all of it. I'm the last class that graduated from the old Blair. I mean, I assume you guys even know there was an old Blair, but I have three younger siblings. They all went to the new Blair. So I would say even my experience compared to their experience was pretty different. I'm really proud of the Blair community and the people that I met there and the experiences. It's something that I struggle to explain to a lot of my friends. I'm like, no, you don't understand. Like, our school was really diverse, more diverse than yours, I guarantee. That's one of the best things that I got from Blair was it really prepared me for the world and taught me how to get along with all kinds of people and how to respect other people. I think that influenced my music a lot. I think it influenced my love of different kinds of food. I think it really just influenced my whole life. I started learning how to play guitar my freshman year of high school, and I used to skip lunch a lot of times and I would go sneak into the band room and I would like take the guitars. But I was kind of like, as soon as the last class was over, I was home. And then I'd be writing songs or I'd be recording them or I was making a lot of movies. I ended up actually going to Emerson College in Boston as a film major. I had a lot of creative friends, and so there was always people who were up for like, hey, you want to try this project or you want to do this thing? You know, there was, okay, maybe my friends don't want to get high and get drunk. Maybe they want to make something we can actually like listen to later or be proud of. So for me, it was really about like having something constructive and creative to do. And now I do it for a living. This album is all sort of 90s alternative stuff, which was about, you know, half my brain back then. But this could have easily been a full 90s hip hop and R&B album as well, because that was really everywhere, you know. And it was Dr. Dre and Tribe Called Quest and Snoop Dogg and that also meant a lot to me, Boys to Men. But I decided to go with the grunge side of things just because it was a little more guitar driven. And I'm always interested in any kind of music and learning new music and trying to understand it. And to me, it's just kind of like food or language. It's just kind of a gateway into a culture. I don't really subscribe to this idea that like the good old days of music or something. I mean, I was getting started in like the mid 2000s. Everyone was telling me then, oh, you really missed the good days of like the 90s or the 80s. But I think that's just something that older people do, is tell people that everything used to be better. And so I think it's just really about figuring out how to do it, how to be smart. I mean, for me, in the very beginning, it was always making sure I was writing my own music, because so I make money from songwriting royalties. I get money from putting my songs in commercials or movies. I get money from going on tour. And I've been really lucky that I've been able to make a living doing this and you know, successful at it. And it's a really exciting time for music. To me, it's like Spotify and streaming stuff. It's totally changed everything. It's changed the way I listen to music. It's changed the way I share music. It's changed the way I record music. When I was in high school, we could do a little bit of recording, but it was, you know, there wasn't the digital landscape that there is now. I didn't have my own laptop that I could record on. So like I saved a bunch of my money and we like had to go into a recording studio and do some recording. Whereas now, you know, obviously I would be at home or people are at home making beats, programming. You can do most things at home. You can share files with people. So I think in most ways, there's never been a better time to be making music, and there's never been a better time to be listening to music. You know, it's not like people are less interested in music. If anything, everyone's like more interested. You can get more footage, you can get more songs. So to me as an artist, that's really exciting, because I'm not just releasing my album, I'm releasing, you know, music videos with it, and I'm releasing, you know, different things that we're doing that all tie together that wouldn't have been able to happen before. I guess in some way I have something in common with the class of 2020, which is sort of like, we sort of graduated and then the thing kind of just evaporated. And you know, there was something weird about that we couldn't ever go back to the school that we all went to. I mean, you can go visit people and visit teachers and things, but it wasn't the same, you know, it wasn't like walking down the hallway and remembering that stuff. So there was something kind of intense about leaving Blair around then. and having this chapter close. Congratulations, class of 2020. You made it through this. This is insane. And there's so much more to do, you know, and like just live your best life, be kind to people, try not to regret anything.